When one chord is not moving properly in the voice box, it results in hoarseness, which is very breathy in nature.
People find it difficult to generate any power.
In fact, they have to produce about 8 times the normal power to get the kind of voice that most people would generate normally. This is very tiring and they run out of breath. Also, because the vocal cords don't come together properly, food and drink might go down the wrong way, and this can lead to problems eating and drinking, particularly problems with fluids, and very occasionally can lead to repeated chest infections. Now, most people with vocal cord paralysis get better over a period of 6 months to a year. And during that time, they can be managed easily by a combination of speech and language therapy and vocal cord injections. Where the paralysis is more permanent, however, we use a different approach. Here we have to push the cords closer together on a permanent basis. And the tried and tested method of doing this is to create a small block of medical grade plastic called silastic and to carve it into a wedge shape that fits into the side of the voice box and pushes the cords closer together. Most recently, however, we've started to introduce a brand new technique called laryngeal re-innovation. And this is where you can take one of the spare nerves in the neck, yes, we do have spare nerves that don't do very much, and you can connect it up to the paralysed vocal cord to give it bulk, tone, and position.